بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
In the name of Allah, the Most Gracious, the Most Merciful.
لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له بيده مقاليد السماوات والأرض إنما أمره إذا أراد شيئا أن يقول له كن فيكون وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله وصفيه وخليله خيرته من خلقه اصطفاه ربه واجتباه أشهد أنه بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الغمة وتركنا على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك فاللهم اجزه عنا وعن الإسلام والمسلمين خير ما جزيت به نبيا عن أمته ورسولا عن قومه اللهم وحينا على سنته وتوفنا على ملته وأوردنا حوضه واسقنا من يده الشريفة شربة هنيئة لا نظمأ بعدها أبدا اللهم اجمع بيننا وبينه كما آمنا به ولم نره اللهم لا تفرق بيننا وبينه حتى تدخلنا مدخلا صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وسلم أجمعين. أما بعد، أيها المسلمون، جاء رمضان وذهب إلى ربه. الله تبارك وتعالى أسأل أن يكون شاهدا لنا لا شاهدا علينا، وأن يكون في ميزان حسناتنا يوم القيامة، وأن يجعلني الله وإياكم وعباده المؤمنين من الذين قبل الله تلاوتهم، صيامهم، قيامهم، ركوعهم، سجودهم، إنه ولي ذلك وهو أرحم الراحمين. أيها المسلمون، جاء رمضان وتركنا مع الدرس العظيم، الدرس العظيم الذي علينا أن نعيشه ما بقينا، درس التقوى. هذا الدرس الذي كلنا حين نقرأ آية الصيام ونختم هذه الآية بقوله عز وجل لعلكم تتقون، التقوى التي نعيشها ليس فحسب في رمضان، ليس فحسب حين نصوم، بل التقوى التي تجعلنا مع ربنا تبارك وتعالى. هذه التقوى، هذا الإحساس الذي يملأ قلب العبد المؤمن المتقي أن الله تبارك وتعالى جل جلاله يطلع عليه، يراه، يسمعه، وهو معكم أينما كنتم، والله بما تعملون خبير. ما يكون من نجوى ثلاثة إلا هو رابعهم، ما تكون في شأن إلا هو معكم. التقوى كما عرف بعض العلماء ألا يراك حيث نهاك وألا يفقدك حيث أمرك، لأنه سبحانه وتعالى جل جلاله لا تغيب عينه سبحانه. هذه التقوى التي توصل العبد في الصلاة، في الصيام، في الأعمال إلى الإحسان. والإحسان هو إتقان العمل. ورسولنا صلى الله عليه وسلم يوصينا إن الله تعالى يحب إذا عمل أحدكم عملا أن يتقنه، أن يحسنه. وأول ما يبدأ الإحسان في القلب، والإحسان كما عرفه رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم حين أجاب جبريل عليه السلام، سأل ما الإحسان؟ قال أن تعبد الله كأنك تراه، أن تعبد الله كأنك تراه، فإن لم تكن تراه فإنه يراك. فالإحسان مقامات. المقام الأول هو أعلى المقامين، أن تعبد الله كأنك تراه، تنظر إليه سبحانه وتعالى. لو تأملنا قليلا لو أي إنسان عاقل أي إنسان عاقل يرى المسؤول عنه يرى الذي يملك عليه شيئا كيف سيتصرف سيتصرف بكل حذر بانتباه سيتصرف ستكون سلوكياته وأعماله بطريقة أنه يعترف بوجود هذا الإنسان أمامه لأنه يراه فإن لم نصل إلى هذا المقام فإن لم تكن تراه فإنه يراه سبحانه جل جلاله هذه التقوى التي نعلم صغارنا حين يصومون ساعتين أو أكثر إذا كان اليوم طويلا كما كان الصيف نعلمهم أن الله سبحانه وتعالى يراهم فإذا جاعوا إذا عطشوا لا يقتربوا من الطعام والشراب لماذا يا بني؟ لماذا يا بنيتي؟ الجواب الذي نحب أن نسمعه لأن الله يطلع عليه لأن الله يراني أن الله معي هذا الدرس الذي يعيشه الولد الصغير البنت الصغيرة ما أحوج أن نعيشه إلى أن نلقى الله سبحانه وتعالى ألم يعلم بأن الله يرى؟ ألم يعلم بأن الله يرى؟ الله سبحانه وتعالى أسأل أن يرزقنا هذه التقوى التي تملأ قلوبنا إنه ولي ذلك والقادر عليه قول الحمد والثناء والشكر والتوفيق أمدته الله أرحم الراحمين جل جلاله أكرم الأكرمين صلاة أن سلام أبو الإمام الأنبياء أو الحبيب محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وصحبه وسلم O Muslims, Ramadan has come, arrived, and then left us. Ramadan has gone back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as all the time passed. And go to Allah jalla jalal. No doubt, every moment of one's life has taken us away from dunya, has taken us closer to meeting with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala jalla jalaluhu. May Allah arham al-rahimeen. I supplicate to him jalla jalaluhu this moment in time. And it is through his rahmat, one of the times that he subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts our du'as. That he jalla jalaluhu accept our siyam, our qiyam, our ruwa, our sujood, our tilawat. And through his rahmat jalla jalaluhu, to put any of these a'mal in the good side of our kitab in the day of Qiyamah. Allahumma ameen, Allahumma ameen, Allahumma ameen. Certainly, we had one of the greatest lessons that we have to carry on and take with us after Ramadan. So Ramadan has gone, but the lesson from Ramadan will never go. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala turn this lesson to live with us. To live with us and not to leave us. To live with us. The lesson is taqwa. This unique concept in Islam. This unique concept in Arabic. Is not just gut feeling. It's not just piety. But it's such energy and power in one's heart. That connects the heart with Allah Jalla Jalaluhu. Connects the heart that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is present in the heart. Whatever the limbs, whatever the parts of the body to make any action, the heart is there, is speaking to the eye, speaking to the ear, speaking to the hands. That Allah jalla jalaluhu is looking at you, Allah is watching you. And without Allah jalla jalaluhu, with many ayahs in the Quran, reminded us that he subhanahu wa ta'ala ma'akum, he's with you, wherever you are. He's watching. He subhanahu wa ta'ala with his eye is seeing everything. And he subhanahu wa ta'ala is never asleep. He subhanahu wa ta'ala is never tired. And one of the first ayahs Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed in Surah Al-Alaq, أَلَمْ يَعْلَمْ بِأَنَّ اللَّهَ يَعْلَمْ. Doesn't he know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sees, that Allah watches? Taqwa in mu'min's heart is to develop is to wear. In a way, that the ibadah of this believer to reach maqam al-ihsan, station of ihsan, the condition that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves to see us doing it. As Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam addressed us, indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves. Will any of you does any act is to do it in a perfect way. In a perfect way. Do it perfectly. And perfection does not come from outside, from the skills, from the caliber that we have to do any amal. It starts from the heart. Starts from what is the motivation of doing any act, regardless what is act you do. Do it to please our Khaliq, the one gives us the life. And it is fair enough, this life should be utilized. Utilized to please the one who is given it, who is in control of it. Every breath we take, in or out, is by no means, but by Allah Jalla Jalal. So each and every of these breath we take in or out, the air comes in, the air goes out, should not be used but to please Him Jalla Jalal. Fair enough. When he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was asked about ihsan, perfection, he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went straight to our relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The reply to Jibreel alayhi salam was, أَن تَعْبُدَ اللَّهَ كَأَنَّكَ تَرَاهُ, is to worship Allah as you see Allah. This is the first maqam, first station. As you look at Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala up there, the eyes of the heart is open. Eyes there is open too. See Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's the basira. That's the eye inside the heart. To see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The second maqam and the last, إِلَّمْ تَكُنْ تَرَىٰ, if you cannot see Him جَلَّ جَلَالُ فَإِنَّهُ يَرَانِ. Surely you have this faith that He subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching. May Allah جَلَّ جَلَالُ to enable our hearts to understand this. Yes, hearts understand. Hearts understand. Before the brains. If we to have these hearts that understand the existence of Allah Jalla Jalaluhu, it is going to be very hard to disobey Allah and to be on and off when the heart goes to sleep. Somehow the existence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is vague to the heart's eye. And then once we have this, we wake up again and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant all of us maghfirat and rahmat. Ameen ya Rabbal Alameen. The lesson that we try to install in our children's hearts to make sure they receive it is the same lesson that we should live with it. When we, the adults, those who observe fasting, when we say to the kids, to the children, if you are fasting 2 hours, or more or less, and you're really hungry, it's going to be long 2 hours. Will you drink? Will you eat? And nobody around you? The answer would like to hear from the child, no, I will not. Then we say, why? Why, my dear daughter, my dear son, why will you do it? The answer, we'd love to hear it from them, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is there. Allah is watching me. Great, mashallah. That is the first lesson in Iman. Allah is watching you, Allah is there. But this in their hearts. The same lesson, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala let us to live this lesson, to take it with us the 11 months that we are in till next Ramadan. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala maghfirat wa rahmah wa tawbah. Allahumma ameen. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfiru Allah li wa lakum wa lisairil muslimin. Tubu ila Allah wa astaghfiru fad-da'im hadithu ar-rahman wad-da'im ila dhanbi kama da'ana. الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضله فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وسلم أجمعين. أما بعد, may I request the brothers please, any space in the front of you, just come closer. And those brothers who are nearby the entrance, please, try to get inside. It's one of the steps Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said. It will be means causing of connecting our hearts with Allah. Any space in front of you, come closer, please. And those brothers who lean against the walls, please. If you don't have any medical reason, any health-wise reason, please, it's comfortable, jazakallah. It's always the respectful sitting to sit on a tashahhud position, as long as you can, of course, in any daras, in any jamaah, jazakallah. Amma ba'd, Muslims, Allah Jalla Jalalu addressed us with the taqwa. When He subhanahu wa ta'ala Jalla Jalalu said, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu taqullaha haqqa tuqatih wa la tamutunna illa wa antum muslimun. The ayah about siyam, as I mentioned for this khutbah, concluded with this, la'allakum tattaqoon. You may gain taqwa, achieve this quality in your heart. In this ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala advise us to have a taqwa as it should be, haqqa tuqati, reality of the taqwa, to be indeed in our hearts. The ayah is followed by another ayah, and I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant me and everyone understanding what is the connection between this ayah that's addressing us about taqwa as it should be and i'tisam bihablillah, that is hold fast with the rope of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that is the Quran, that is the Sunnah, that is the Islam, and not to be disunited. And if we are disunited, and if we are in groups, and if we are in sects, we will have fire in dunya before the fire in the hereafter. And we will suffer here in a way that nobody can help, except if we ourselves to stop our hands from doing this evil act of scattering, disuniting, grouping the Muslims. If we still think that we can work for a group, work for a movement, work for a sheikh, or work for a peer, or a president, forgetting that work for Islam first. And we cannot see the difference between working for or working with. Working for, it is Islam. Working with, a group, a movement, whatsoever title they have. And I believe every group, with no exception, they try to get the best title that's appealing to everyone. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us with the group, the movement, that will appreciate. Those appreciate. Everyone is doing any good thing for Islam. Even appreciate kuffar, deniers, non-Muslims, when they do something good for us. We got to be appreciative. مَنْ لَا يَشْكُرُ النَّاسِ لَا يَشْكُرُ اللَّهِ. If we cannot thank people, we cannot thank the Lord of people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The ayah reads, after this, حَقَّ تُقَاتِلْ وَلَا تَمُتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ وَاعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا وَاذْكُرُوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ إِذْ كُنْتُمْ أَعْدَاءً فَأَلَّفَ بَيْنَ قُلُوبِكُمْ فَأَصْبَحْتُمْ بِنِعْمَتِهِ إِخْوَانَ. Even if we group, if we make our movement with a big title could be read as Al-Muhajirun Al-Ansar, as happened in Medina Al-Munawwara. When some from Al-Muhajirun, from the young kids, kicked the Ansari boy, the Ansari hit back. The two boys cried out, "Oh Muhajirin," and the other one cried, "Oh Ansar." And the people from Muhajirun became very upset. Ansar also became very upset, and Muhajirun as a group, as a movement, if we can say it, they were trying to do something, shouting at each other. The people of Medina is our city. You are foreigners, in a way. The Muhajirun, you are this, that. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, oh Allah, come to know about this. And he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came barefooted, walking to them. I say, أَبِدَعْوَ الْجَهِلَيَّةِ وَأَنَا بَيْنَ أَظْهُرِكُمْ. The call of jahiliyyah, the call of ignorance, and I am still amongst you. And what they cried out, Muhajirin and Ansar. Great titles. So if we Muslims don't understand, it has been very long, not just yesterday, literally yesterday or last week or last month, it's been very long. Put the blame on others, thinking they are clever in tricksology, tricks. The enemies of Islam, they do this and do that. They should have free hands to do whatever they want. But to blame ourselves. When we so meek and weak that we don't use our brains. What a small sect, another small or big or party or group fighting each other. We're making dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to save the blood of Muslims. But first to save blood of Muslims from the Muslim hands. Subhanallah, it's very strange in these days. Muslim hands killing each other. Asking Allah Jalla Jalla, pray to Him. This is the minimum we can offer our brothers and sisters. To pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah please show them your rahmat. Allah please be there for them. Allah, please unite their hearts. They still all come together in one masjid. Subhanallah, same people, they come in one masjid when they go out, even sometime in the masjid. La hawla wa la quwwata illa, we don't have to speak much. Being killed inside masjid. Nothing but to cry to Allah Jalla Jalaluhu and to raise our hands. That Ya Allah, be there for the ummah of your Habib Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You are the one brought the hearts of Ansar and Muhajirin. You are the one brought the people from different sects, different backgrounds, different colors together. Salman al-Farsi, Suhaib al-Rumi, Bilal al-Habashi, Abu Bakr al-Siddiq al-Arabi. Ya Allah, brought their hearts together. Ya Allah, please. Ya Allah, please. Your rahmat. Ya Allah, be there for us, Ya Rabb al-Alameen. Show us a way out, Ya Rabb al-Alameen. From all the crises in this ummah, Ya Rabb al-Alameen. Ya Allah, give us the mahabbat. Together. And Ya Allah, lead us to learn how to debate, how to be different, and yet not to have broken hearts. Ya Rahman Allah. Allahumma ja'al jama'ana hadha jama'an marhuma, wa ja'al tafarruqna min ba'dihi tafarruqan ma'suma, wa na'udhu bika an taj'ala fiina aw bainana aw hawlana shakiyyan aw mahruma. Allahumma arina al-haqq haqqan warzuqna ittiba'ah. وارنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه واجعلنا اللهم من الراشدين. اللهم من ارادنا والاسلام والمسلمين بخير فوفقه لكل خير. ومن ارادنا والاسلام والمسلمين بسوء فاجعل كيدهم في نحورهم واجعل تدميرهم في تدبيرهم. واهلكم كما لك عاد وثمود ان لم يكن من نصيبهم الهدايه فانك ولي ذلك وانت القادر عليه. اللهم هيئ لهذه الامه امر رشد. أمرا يعز فيه أهل طاعتك ويؤدى فيه أهل معصيتك ويؤمر فيه بالمعروف وينهى فيه عن المنكر ويحكم فيه بكتابك وسنة حبيبك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وأنت المستعان عليك البلاغ. وآخر الصلاة.